Adler and Sullivan and Frank Lloyd Wright are long gone, and some of their architectural wonders are gone. But many have survived, and with the new Chicago School of Architecture, Richard Bennett says Chicago will survive. Ready for the close. Keep your head up. Look. Oh. Mr. Bennett, may I have your name and title for identification?
My name is Richard Bennett, and I am about to become a senior fellow at Harvard, and I have been an architect here in Chicago for the last 30 years.
Mr. Bennett, what would you say about the Chicago School of Architecture that was so famous in the late 19th century, and how would you compare it to the School of Architecture that we see in the new buildings in the downtown today?
Well, the better bookkeeping makes it so that they can measure building performance better, so that there are forces that make architecture were not considered so much days gone by.
Do we have any wonders of the world standing now in downtown Chicago?
Well, I think that all you have to do is the number of people, the visitors, and how they are amazed, really, by our buildings. The thing is, we're pretty well concentrated, so you can see them all. Chicago is tightly knit downtown. And so that a short walk must be sort of an astounding thing for many of the visitors to see these great things rise up.
What about some of these buildings? Is the Hancock a wonder?
Yes, I certainly it's if you take a word wonder, it's a wonder. I want to tell you a story, and that is, if you wonder enough about something, then it becomes wonderful, and so people must wonder about what goes on in. They must wonder how they came about. They must wonder the difference, so that the city is a wonderful place for people to come.
Right, what are wonderful buildings?
And the interesting thing is the difference in the decoration of the four buildings. One very classical, one Gothic, one the new modern at 333, and then it's hard to say, just the almost wedding cake, the Wrigley building. So that, and then the fortuitous jog, the doesn't go straight across the street. That whole thing is a result. And if it had been all squared up, it wouldn't have anything. But you have a sense of growth, then something that's organic that's at the bottom of that whole thing. I mean, it's how you could describe what makes people react is hard. But back here, they much more than they think they're thinking. And that's, I think, where the gratification comes from. That whole North Street with the jogs in it, which were not planned, they were fortuitous, they were accidental. That's what makes, of course, European cities so interesting, because they grew. So what am I saying? I'm saying you have to beware a little bit of planned things. Geometry is more important than the terrain. New York has great high buildings. Right now, it seems to me they're wiggling them a little bit too much, and the 45 degree is now fashionable instead of the 90. But I think that our towers, which stand up pretty clean, are very unique and look historically great buildings. These are the buildings that give value to a culture. If each generation would tear down what their fathers did, it would be a sorry thing. And these are more than memorials. They are milestones on the development of things. And the more one knows history backwards, the more you can have faith in history forwards.
But we've lost the old Stock Exchange building, and we've replaced it with a modern office building, and nobody wants to rent there.
Well, I can't say I'm sorry for the people who did it, because they had a chance to try to work out some kind of a transfer. There were all kinds of people who were trying to help save that building, and they just said, we're going to make so much money out of it, we can't afford it, and fought the thing. So once in a while, the books get balanced correctly.
Architecturally, how would you rate downtown Chicago with some of the finer cities?
Well, I think that we have a pretty strong, unified, the basic Burnham plan gave us a pretty good matrix in which to build the building. I think that the three great public plazas that have resulted, in many cases, from the zoning law of some years ago, that allowed, that actually made it profitable, leave space, has been very, very successful. So you have the Federal Plaza, you got the First National Bank Plaza, and we have the Civic Center Plaza. And I think I don't believe any of us who have been around realize how they have changed the core, the inner core of the city. So that actually the Great North Michigan Avenue doesn't have the same taste anymore. The real life has been pulled back where the people are. Now, it's pretty interesting that the Burnham plan, which we all think so much of, it had a civic center. It was even further back than ours. It was back in Halsted Street. Unfortunately, he had great imagination, and the things he built were taller than they could build at that time. And apparently it frightened everybody else off. And so it was agreed that that part of the plan would not go ahead. And to my mind, that was probably the best part of the plan, because it pushed the center of the city closer to the center where things are. And it's a tragedy that hasn't gone through. One of the things I think, and I know people are trying to do it now, but I think that our Burnham plan needs a terrific review. And I'm wondering if we shouldn't probably have a brand new plan that is much more attuned to the neighborhoods. The thing that's unhappy about Chicago is the deterioration of the material around the center of the city. This is what I think we should be worrying about. Now, there's a new big project to the south, Chicago 21, which has great promise. I just read in the paper today how many decades it will take to complete that. But meanwhile, I feel that probably we should bring in some top social scientists and study the people in the town and what they really need. You know, if it wasn't for people, we wouldn't need architects. We wouldn't need buildings. And what worries me more and more about this is that in all the architectural schools I have taught in or been taught in, I never had a course in people. But I think this is changing. The number of books on behaviorism and things and applied behavior is multiplying just in the last year and a half. And I believe that some of these new approaches are more in-depth, they're not more approach, they're just broader. I think somehow Chicago should really bring in some and use some of their own people to think about the city as people. I think we've got most of them housed, certainly for the working places, for some of the great factories. All of that is well done, but I'm not too sure about the quality of so many of the places we live in.